This is for my ancestors, both known and unknown. May this serve you wherever you are and wherever you may go. Greetings everyone and welcome back to my channel. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and comment on this video. I realize that I didn't say that in my previous video, but words are just as powerful as writing something down to manifest it. So I'm putting it out into the universe to help my channel grow. Today I'm going to be talking about ancestral altars, or more specifically my ancestral altar. And the reason that I chose this topic for this video is that I did a poll on both of my business pages for Chi.Aura.Crystals. And it was between ancestor altars or pendulum divination. And of course, ancestor altars won, so I'm gonna save pendulum divination for another video at a later time. But I wanted to, of course, give you a oversight of what this video was gonna be about. So let's get right into it. I like to use the incense smoke as a form of cleansing because I don't personally cleanse every single thing that touches my altar. It really just depends on what it is. The candles, I spray with Florida water. My pendulum, I'll spray with Florida water or Palo Santo spray. My ankh, I cleansed it. My cowrie shells, I cleansed them. So like I said, it just depends on what it is that I'll do a intentional cleanse on that item, but overall I like how the incense smoke just kind of moves around and touches a little bit of everything on the altar. Now to speak on the things that I have on my altar, as I just said, I have the ankh, which is the Egyptian symbol of life. I actually had this tattooed on the inside of my arm with my mother's name in it to represent who she was and her, as I always like to tell people, breathing life into me. And the candles that are here are normally here, but that's when I don't have them lit. I don't like to light them and then leave them right here because this is such a low surface or overhead area. I don't know what the correct wording would be for it. In this cup, this is just a regular glass, I should say, that I got from Dollar Tree. And it has filtered water and Florida water mixed together in it. And this is one of the things that I have to actually refresh as an offering. So if you can see the lines here, this is where it was and this is where it is now. So I always look at that as them enjoying that offering because it evaporates very quickly. The first time I did it, it was gone probably in, I want to say about 3 days. It was gone so quick, and that was the first time I did it. And I find that when you first put a certain type of offering out, it disappears really quickly. It's like, oh, they're so happy to get it. So this has to be redone. And what I'll do is just pour this out, clean the inside of the glass, fill it up with water, and add Florida water to it. Okay, so I have my Florida water, my filtered water in my glass, and I washed this out, dried it, and then put the filtered water in it. I also went ahead and filled this one up, which is just the plain filtered water offering. And this glass is actually a candle holder, but if you can see the glare of it, it has like that rainbow aura tint to it, and I just thought that was the perfect thing to put on my altar. So I'm using a candle holder. So I like to do an offering of water with Florida water as well as just regular water by itself. And I'll just pour some in there as much as I feel is needed. It turns the water cloudy. And I put it back underneath. And this one actually goes down here, which is a little trickier for me to do because it's in this little corner area. Cowrie shells, I ordered these off of Etsy. And I was originally looking for these, which are called tiger cowrie shells. And I, of course, got two of them because I believe they came in a set of two. But then I saw these as I was looking, and I just had to have them because they're so beautiful, and that purple color on them. My mom's favorite color was purple, as you can see from her picture. And it just felt like I had to have both. So I ended up with four. I cleansed them all and put them on my altar just wherever I could fit them. And the significance of Chi.Aura shells is that they represent goddess protection. They are very, very, very strongly connected to the ocean and the strength of the ocean. And that is significant for these seashells too. We picked those off of the beach in Clearwater, I believe. We took a family trip to Clearwater, which is about an hour and a half away, so like a weekend stay. And I wanted to add seashells, and that was in the power of three, of course. So those are there as another form of water offering. Lots and lots of water offerings on my altar.
I have a oil offering,
which this is just something I felt guided to do. And I don't really refill this as much because the oil doesn't go anywhere, really. It kind of just stays right here at this level. When I first put it out, it did kind of evaporate a little bit. And I find that when you first put an offering out, that first taste of it always goes away immediately. But after I refilled it, it kind of just stays at the steady level. And this is a mix of High John the Conqueror and a divine blessing oil, which is a ancestor oil. I have my mini Dutch oven, which I use to burn ancestor money. And you can see these are ashes of bills that I've already burned. I like to hold on to my ashes until I'm ready to dispose of them. And disposing of them, I actually will take them outside and just kind of pour them out, let them fly away with the wind. So I'm actually going to burn some ancestor money in this video just to show you my process with doing that. This is what ancestor money looks like, or this is one of the ways that it looks like. And I got this locally at a Asian market. It's on Amazon as well, but I'm impatient and I wanted it that day because I was doing it in a ritual. So I wanted to have it at that moment and didn't want to wait. So I found it, I called and asked an Asian market that's near me if they carried it, and they did. And I got it for $4 or $5, I think. Not that expensive, and I have this much, and I burnt some, so this is how much I still have left. Of course, I have my money jar. You all are familiar with this from my previous video. You put this on my altar because that amplifies the power of it. Anything like this, or I shouldn't say anything, but certain things I just feel are important to place there. And this is definitely one of those. I also have these two little herb offerings, herb and oil offerings. And I made these initially to do a jar spell. And I basically missed a step in doing them. So I remade them, but I didn't want to just throw these away. So I used them as an offering because these are love oils and love herbs inside of here. And what better way to show my love to my ancestors than to give them something full of love, you know? I also have a little bottle of Bacardi, an alcohol offering. This is very common on an ancestor altar. And I leave the lid just kind of slightly loose to give them access to it. But surprisingly enough, it's been at this amount, which maybe I should take the top off of it. I've just been a little bit paranoid to do that because I have so many liquids in the area already. I don't know who drank this specifically, but I used my pendulum to ask if I should do an alcohol offering, because initially I was giving wine because that's what I was drinking. So I was basically sharing what I had, and I asked if they wanted an alcohol offering, and I can't remember if I asked if they wanted rum or if I asked if they wanted a specific kind, but I asked for alcohol and the answer was yes. So I just went out and bought something in a glass bottle that I could put on my altar for them. Actually, I am going to take the top off because I want to now see how much this goes away, how much they drink this up. I also have my pendulum on my altar, and I leave it there because I'm communicating with them when I use this, so it's very important and significant for me to leave it there. This is a smoky quartz pendulum that I bought locally probably about 4 years ago now. And I have another one. I actually just ordered another one for myself so that I can keep it with me, because sometimes I'm not home and I have a question and I need them to guide me. But with this one being the one that I use on my altar, I like to keep it there. I feel that it's very important to keep the items that you bought for your altar on your altar. Don't take from them, basically. I have crystals on my altar as well, and I chose them based on what their properties were. A rose quartz for love. A moonstone for intuition. A clear quartz point to amplify. Citrine for prosperity. And prenite, which is considered the healer's crystal. It's the crystal that heals the healer. A little green Buddha that I got from a local store here in Orlando. I'm not a Buddhist, but I just felt like this was something cute that I could add as another form of representing wealth and representing prosperity for them on the other side. I have this little decoration of words that says, I love you, a bushel and a peck and a hug around the neck, which is something that my mama actually used to say to me when I was little. So that had a very, very deep meaning for me. And I bought it when I first started my business, because this area used to originally be crystal storage. But when I realized I was ready to create my own altar, it was the perfect thing to add along with pictures, which her picture at the top beside it. And then I have a picture of my auntie here and a picture of my baba. And I chose their pictures because they are the three that I feel most connected to. Yes, I have a lot of other relatives, known and unknown, but as far as who I feel connected to, who I feel I get my guidance from, it's my mama, my auntie, and my baba. I bought some new flowers for an offering. These are pink carnations that I got from Publix, and roses as well. The carnations, I actually found out, are my favorite flower. So I love to keep carnations on my altar. I don't choose them necessarily for their color. I just kind of choose what sticks out to me. So I guess in a sense that is for the color, but I don't choose the same color. I just kind of go to the store as soon as I walk in, because when I walk into the Publix that's near my house, the flowers are right there. So I can walk in the door and literally already see what colors are there, and I just go with what catches my eye first. And in this instance, it was these beautiful pink ones, which this one's actually, oh, she's dying. So I'll put that one outside with these, because these are the ones that I'm going to be taking off of my altar. I don't really like to let them get like this. It's very important not to let anything die on your altar. This is considered the flowers dying. So I try not to let them get like this, which they're not completely dying. These ones are still fully bloomed, but that one there, I'll just put outside with these, because I don't like to dispose of them in the sense of just putting them in the trash. I like to give them back to the earth. So if you ever saw my yard, I have a lot of old flowers just kind of disintegrating in my yard because I just think it's important to give it back to the earth. I give my herbs back to the earth, like when I'm packing orders or dressing candles and I spill herbs. I don't like to use those herbs if I've spilled them, so I just collect them, and when I'm done collecting them, I'll just kind of throw them outside in front of my house somewhere. I do the same thing with crystals. Like if I break a crystal or there's crystal fragments from my new inventory, I put it back outside. So I'm going to be switching those out. I'll probably actually do that off camera just because it's a little bit of a process, but I'll show you what they look like afterwards.
I had the intention of doing a full moon bath. The full moon was in Cancer, which is my zodiac sign. I was born July 21st, so I'm right on the cusp between Cancer and Leo, but I'm still a Cancer. And I bought the roses because they represent protection, among other things, as far as their properties go. So I was going to do a bath with the roses, and I was going to create an herb mix to do an herbal tea bath with herbs that had protection properties. Now, I prepared to do all of this, and of course the moon was out. So I took a picture of the moon, and in the moon, there was this image. And I'm going to attach the image into the video along with a quick like 30 second video of me using my pendulum. And what happened is I took the picture and there was this green orb in the picture. Now, whenever I take a moon picture, there somehow or some way or another is always an orb in the picture. So I don't pay much mind to them, although I do believe that orbs represent spirits. What someone pointed out to me, a friend of mine pointed out to me, is that the clouds looked like an image of someone. And she put a screenshot of pictures of my mom into my comments on that and asked me if I felt like it looked like her. Now, of course, I'm like, I don't see what you're seeing until she actually pointed it out to me. And then I was just kind of like, whoa, like, not in the sense of because my mom visited me, just because her visits are rare. She's been gone almost 6 years, and I would say that was maybe the third visit I've gotten from her, the second that I've gotten from her since she's been gone, aside from me just being able to communicate with her through my pendulum. So of course, with that being pointed out to me, I wanted confirmation. I wanted to know, okay, is this my mama? Is this her visiting me? Because it looked like in the image that someone was stretching back as if they were doing yoga. And my mom did yoga. So it was like, it was just so many things coming together in that picture for me. And like I said, I'm going to insert the picture into the video as well as the video of me using my pendulum to ask if it was her. And I asked twice and it said yes. So that was my confirmation that my mama was coming to visit me on the full moon in Cancer on Friday. And it was just, it almost knocked me off my feet because it was just such a powerful moment. Like it, for me, with it happening on the full moon and happening under the full moon in Cancer, when I was younger or growing up, I should say, my mom taught me to put the white light around people, put the white light around myself, put the white light around those that I love, those that I care for, as a form of protection. And I still, to this day, at 27, do that. I put the white light around myself, my family, my car. I'm trying to keep myself safe in my car. And I do it for my family members, and I do it for my friends and those close to me if I know they need it. And with the moon being full, of course, there's the white light around the moon. And I just felt like that was the biggest form of protection right there. Like anything that I could do at that moment was no longer needed because my mom just came through with this confirmation to say, you're protected. I got you. You're good. Like, and now basically I have two bouquets of flowers. So that's just gonna be a double flower offering because like I said, I normally will do the carnations at the top. And now I have the roses, but I don't feel the need to do the bath anymore. So I'm just gonna push them off into the corner and provide them as a second offering. But yeah, I think you guys are gonna really be shocked by the video. I'm not shocked because I know my connection with my mom, whether she visits me or not. My connection is still very much like this. So it was just, I didn't expect it because her visits are very rare. I'm pretty sure that was the second that I've gotten from her that I can recall with her being gone almost 6 years now. So yes, very, very, very powerful, very comforting, very reassuring, very just, I don't know, that was just like love from the other side.
Show me yes. Show me no. Show me yes. Show me no. Mama, was that you in the clouds? Mommy, was that you in the clouds?
Now I'm going to show you how I burn my ancestor money and what I say while I'm burning it, and that will actually complete my process for me with my altar. Everybody's process is different. This is just what I do with mine and what I do with my offerings. There's a lot of options that you can do here. There are a lot of possibilities here, but this is just me showing you guys what I do for mine and how I got the ideas to choose different things for mine. So I'm gonna take 3 of the hell notes. And I'll light the first one. And when I light them and let them burn, I always like to say this. This is for my ancestors, both known and unknown. May this serve you where you are and wherever you may go. And I stick it in and I let it burn, which it looks like this one actually needs more flame, more fire. And I'll do the same thing. This is for my ancestors, both known and unknown. May this serve you wherever you are and wherever you may go. And they burn really high up, so you have to watch that. This is for my ancestors, both known and unknown. May this serve you wherever you are and wherever you may go. This is what it looks like after it's burned. Sometimes they burn all the way down to ash, like the smaller pieces you see, and sometimes they stay like this. But like I said, I will take them outside and just let them go to release them. I don't like to throw them directly in the trash. That just doesn't feel right to me. But for now, I'm just gonna put the lid on it. And that seals everything that I needed to do with my altar.
I hope you found this video helpful if you are looking into starting your own altar for your ancestors to honor them. If you have any questions, definitely please comment them down below and I'll do the best that I can to answer them. I can't guarantee that I'll have an answer because your altar is going to be specific to you. I do feel that if you aren't able to identify or find out what relatives you can or cannot, for lack of a better term, put on your altar, because I know some people are leaving Christianity and now coming into the spiritual, and their concern is going to be, okay, well, if my relatives were Christian, can I then put them on my altar? So I feel that the same sense of me saying to my ancestors, both known and unknown, that that's something that you could do yourself to honor them, just because you are speaking, you are calling to them, even if you don't know who they are, you are calling to them from yourself. And you can put out offerings to them, even if you don't know them, still to honor them, to let them know that this is for them, although they are unknown to you, that there's nothing wrong with doing that at all. If you have any questions about anything that I specifically did in my video and anything that I have on my altar, definitely please comment that below as well. And that's all. Until next time.